girl I was last night.
You were?
I didn't know what to do or where to go. And suddenly, my feet started walking me down the street, across the bridge, past the Metropole Cinema, and do you know where?
No. Where?
Right into the library.
The library?
Can you imagine?
Well, how did you like it?
You've never seen such a place. So many books. So much marble. And so quiet. And suddenly, all of my confidence dribbled away with a pitiful plop. My head was beginning to swim, and my forehead was covered with cold perspiration. I started to reach for a book, and my hand automatically came to a stop. I don't know how long I stood frozen, a victim of panic and mortification. Oh, how I wanted to flee. When a gentle voice, a quiet voice, whispered, "Pardon me."
Pardon me?
And there was this dear, sweet, clearly respectable, thickly bespectacled man who stood by my side and quietly said to me, "Ma'am, don't mean to intrude, but I was just wondering, are you in need of some help?" I said, "No, yes, I am." The next thing I know, I'm sipping hot chocolate and telling my troubles to Paul, whose tender brown eyes kept sending compassionate looks. A trip to the library has made a new girl of me, for suddenly I can see the magic of books. I have to admit, in the back of my mind, I was praying he wouldn't get fresh. And all the while, I was wondering why an illiterate girl should attract him. When all of a sudden, he said, "I couldn't go wrong with The Way of All Flesh." Of course, it's a novel, but I didn't know, or I certainly wouldn't have smacked him. Well, he gave me a smile that I couldn't resist, and I knew at once how much I liked this optometrist.
Optometrist?
Optometrist. You know what this dear, sweet, slightly bespectacled gentleman said to me next? He said he could solve this problem of mine. I said, "How?" He said, "If I'd like, he'd willingly read to me some of his favorite things." I said, "When?" He said, "Now." His novel approach seemed highly suspicious and possibly dangerous too. I told myself, "Wait, think, dare you go up to his flat?" He read to me all night long. Now how about that? It's hard to believe how truly domestic and happily hopeful I feel. I picture my Paul there reading aloud while I cook. As long as he's there to read, there's quite a good chance indeed, a chance that I'll never need to open a book. Like someone else, someone I dimly recall, I know he'll only have eyes for me, my optometrist.